Hey, I'm Scott Monty.
Hi, this is Chris Brogan.
Hi, I'm Darren Rouse.
I'm Steve Rebell.
Hi, I'm Mari Smith, and you're watching Social Media Examiner TV.
Michael Stelzner here from Social Media Examiner, and I'm joined today by Scott Monty, head of social media for Ford Motor Company. Scott, how are you doing today?
I'm doing great, Mike. Great to be here.
So there's this really awesome car behind us, and I know there's a social media story behind it. Why don't you tell us what's the car and what's the story behind
it? Sure. Well, we've got social media stories behind most of our cars, but this is the brand new Ford Taurus. This is the show edition.
It's a very
high
nice
output.
Car.
It is. It's a very nice looking car. You're going to get V8 performance out of this car, so we're not sacrificing that. You're going to get V6 fuel economy, right?
Cool.
This is part of our plan on fuel economy for millions of people. This summer, we took the Taurus show to 100 cities, and 10 of those cities we actually picked to do tweet-ups in.
Wow.
And we brought our executive team out there to actually tweet from the event, as well as to interact with bloggers that were there, and to get bloggers in the vehicle and actually doing drives. And it was a phenomenal success.
So talk to me about, once the bloggers got in the car, what did they do after that? Were they going back saying, hey, we love the car, writing about it?
Well, typically the reaction, and we see this about a lot of our new vehicles, people get inside and they look around, or they look at the outside of the car and they go, whoa, this is a Ford? Yeah, this is the new Ford, all right? So I think that surprise and delight is really happening. And then once they get in and feel the experience and feel the difference, they see why it is we're so confident about the way the company's going, the way our great products are evolving.
Well, Scott, you've been doing some great stuff with social media for Ford. Give some advice to your peers out there that may be working for other companies, big or small. What kind of advice would you give them when it comes to social media campaigns? What would be some of the things you might recommend?
Well, I think when companies get involved in social media in general, they need to make sure they've got the support of senior leadership. That
gotcha.
Goes without saying, because if it's just a grassroots effort, unless it's a single person shop or a small shop, it's probably going to fail.
Right.
By having the support of leadership, you get the exposure, you get the potential for budgetary concerns taken care of, and there begins to be a momentum. And there's the opportunity to cross-pollinate. It's not just a marketing exercise or just a PR exercise. It's something that can be done collectively.
So how do you go about getting, at a big corporation, the approval of senior management? Do you say, hey, we're going to go out on Twitter, please help us, or what?
Well, it's funny. Senior management at Ford actually determined that this position needed to be created.
Oh, really?
So there was no upsell required. The notion was, we've been doing social media as a hobby for a while. Let's get serious about it. Let's put some strategy in place and put some leadership in place and do whatever it is we have to do to be relevant and to be the leader in the field. And that's where we are right now.
So, Scott, some of the things that you've done have really helped Ford connect with people at a very kind of a human level, if you will. How is it that social media has helped Ford connect with people, and how has it helped the Ford brand? I mean, can you give me some examples?
Well, if you think about where Ford came from in its earliest days, it was associated with a human being, Henry
right.
Ford, right? And I came from outside of the auto industry. Whether that's a detriment or it was assisting me remains to be seen. But my view of Ford at the time was just this blue oval, which
right.
was very impersonal. There was no personality to it. And to the degree I began to study what Alan Mulally was doing, I began to identify with him as an individual within Ford.
Right.
And that's the exact model we've taken to social media. Because really, that's what it's all about. It's
people.
About relationships, and it's about people. And if we can show the humans, the real people behind the blue oval, who are to a person passionate about this company and wanting it to succeed, and having great products to stand behind and having a strong business plan, that all comes through.
Absolutely. So how do you guys track the metrics from social media? I mean, this is one of the big questions everybody in the social media world wants to know. How do we know things are working? What kind of metrics do you guys do at Ford, and what are the things you're looking for?
Well, when we look at metrics against social media, we don't look at it as a broad category. We look at it programmatically.
Okay.
So with the Summer of Taurus, we knew what the level of awareness was beforehand. We knew what people's perception of the brand was beforehand. Then we go back afterwards, and we've got all sorts of anecdotal commentary, as well as lift in the actual numbers. And we've seen a rise in the number of
mentions?
A number of things. Mentions, certainly. But positive perceptions and great associations with the Ford Taurus, it's been rising each of the last 3 months as a result.
Are you able to tie that directly back to social media, or is it kind of a fuzzy thing?
Well, it's funny. Because social media, we don't do things as a standalone. It's
yeah.
integrated with all of our approaches. There's nothing that is absolutely associated with social media at the largest level as far as perception and intent to buy.
Right.
But when you look at a program like the one we did at Blog Her, we asked those women before they showed up at our Chicago assembly plant for, you know, some of the stuff you're going to see here on the show floor, how many of them or what percentage of them would consider buying Ford? It was 25% before we did the event.
And after?
Afterwards, 98%.
Wow.
Would consider buying Ford.
That's amazing.
It is.
So give some advice to your peers who are thinking about getting into social media, and there's so many who haven't yet. What's some of the big mistakes that you've seen happen, and how can others avoid them?
Well, I think to the degree some people just fall in love with a tool, that's a mistake. You don't have a Twitter strategy or a blog strategy. You have a social media strategy that's tied to your overall marketing and communications goals, okay? And then you figure out what the tools are. But having the plan in place is important first. Because let's not forget, most of these tools are free.
Right.
And we don't have any control over them. And they could disappear tomorrow for all we know.
Gotcha.
So we need to be prepared culturally and as far as having a business plan, how we go about that. So don't fall in love with the tools first. Strategy first, tools second.
So Scott, rumor has it that you can do impersonations. And as a matter of fact, I've heard you have about 28 varieties of Simpsons impersonations.
Well, you can't prove that.
So let's talk a little bit about let's just get a little fun here. If Homer Simpson had access to Twitter at the nuclear plant, what kind of stuff do you think he'd be talking about?
Ooh, Twitter. tweet, tweet, tweet. I don't know what the hell I'm supposed to be doing on this thing.
And what do you think his wife, Marge, would be saying?
You shouldn't be spending all day on Twitter, homie.
Okay, I just had to ask you about that.
So hey, don't forget about me. Oh. I got something for Twitter, too.
I think you got a second career, maybe on America's Got Talent.
Hardly.
So
I'll keep my day job.
Last question. What's in store with Ford when it comes to social media strategy or anything else related to the future in Ford?
Well, I think the next step, and this is the next step with our marketing and really our product development as well, is globalization. You know, how do we take what we've done and what we've perfected in certain areas of the world and apply that across all of our departments, all of our regions? It's going to be a challenge, okay? We have a strategy that is global in nature, but the actual regional executions are what are going to be the most difficult. And we need to make sure we're cross-training staff so that they're educated on what this is and how it can be natural as part of their day-to-day activities.
Scott, where can people learn more about you?
About Ford?
You, Ford?
Me? Well, you can learn more about Ford and all of our great social media activities on thefordstory.com.
Thefordstory.com
or fordstory.com. We bought both, so you'll get there.
What about Twitter?
You can find us on Twitter as Ford.
Okay.
That's our corporate one. We've got a number of them. If you want to follow me, just scottmonty.com will get you there.
All right. Scott, thank you so much.
All right. Thank you, Mike.
Have a good one.
Pleasure.